The question of growth in the economy has always been a topical one. In fact, it is something that continually occupies the attention of those whose task it is to balance the economy and maintain acceptable levels of foreign exchange reserves. But as we now learn from the central bank's governor, Dr. Dilal Worrell, there are a number of things that we must do if this acceptable level is to be maintained.
The first thing that we have to do is to protect the gains that we have already made over the last four decades. In the mid-1970s, our economy was on par with the economies of Guyana, and the big difference that has characterized us ever since is that we have been able to protect the value of our dollar. A lot of other things have been made possible because we have done that.
Growing the sector includes increasing our competitiveness. However, selling things more cheaply and offering our services at a cheaper rate are not the types of competitiveness of which the governor speaks.
Rather, it is about giving people value for money. It is about the what are called the non-price competitiveness aspects.
A point supported by the president of the Barbados Private Sector Association, John Williams.
We need to be more competitive, we need to be more productive, because that will generate both local investment as well as attract foreign investment.
Competitiveness of tourism, competitiveness of international business, and all the other goods and services that we sell overseas.
We are competing in a world of Asia, of Africa, and so on. And therefore, we have to benchmark ourselves against those countries.
There's an organization, and you might have heard of it, called the World Economic Forum, which publishes a global competitiveness index, and Barbados does not do too badly. In fact, it is ranked 44th out of 140 countries.
However, they also identify the items that are the biggest hindrances to a business efficiency within each country. And for Barbados, the third in importance in terms of things that are inhibiting our competitiveness is work attitudes, poor work attitudes.
Thankfully, all is not lost. The governor believes that this is something that all of us can improve on. But how do we do so?
If each one makes the commitment to deliver the services that we are employed to do to the very best of our ability and in the most professional and efficient manner, then we can make our individual contribution to improving the competitiveness with which Barbados is regarded in the international community. And in that way, make our individual contribution to the growth of our economy.
Unfortunately, there are some inhibitors to this growth and success of the economy.
The number one inhibitor is the inefficiency of the government bureaucracy. And it is something which, again, is part of what reduces our competitiveness score.
To the extent that we are able to remedy that, to the extent that our government is able to deliver the services that public servants are expected to deliver, and to deliver them in a timely fashion.
To that extent, each and every public servant is also contributing to improving our competitiveness, improving the advantage that we have relative to all others in terms of growing our foreign exchange sectors.
Now, Dr. Worrell reminds us of the importance of ensuring that public servants understand that through their work, they are making a contribution to the growth of the local economy.
The growth of this economy depends on our competitiveness. Our competitiveness depends on improving government services.
Our future rests with us. It really, we do not have to look outside for someone to give us either large grants or largesse or so on. We have all the raw materials here with our education system, with our people, with our history, with our stability, with our institutions to succeed in the world. We have to look within to do what we have to do and not look outside.
All in an attempt to preserve our foreign exchange reserves. Foreign exchange, the lifeblood of our economy. And so we conclude this informative series. Special thanks to our sponsors, the Central Bank of Barbados, and thank you for viewing. Until our next informative series, I'm Shane Seeley. Goodbye for now.